To the crisis in Ukraine now. There is a big new development tonight. Ukraine will send a delegation to meet with Russian negotiators tomorrow at the Ukraine-Belarus border. But President Volodymyr Zelensky says he does not expect much to come out of the meeting. Also, the United Nations Security Council voted to convene a special session of the UN General Assembly. Now, according to Ukrainian officials, 352 civilians have been killed since the Russian invasion began. And that includes 14 children. There is also news that Russia has taken control of Berdyansk, a city of about 100,000 people in the southern part of Ukraine. Fighting is intensifying in the country's second largest city, Kharkiv. Now in the capital, Kyiv, people are lining up for weapons to help defend their country.
Kyiv is not only the symbol, it's our native city, and we want to make sure that the world knows that Russia's main target is right now to take the city.
The U.S. Embassy in Russia is warning Americans to leave immediately due to canceled flights and more airspace closing to Russian airlines. Thousands in Ukraine are trying to escape the violence, many crowding into the central railway station in Lviv, hoping to find their way to safety. Families are being separated, women and children leaving, while men have to stay behind to fight for their country. Here's ABC's Aaron Katursky.
Lviv's central railway station is a hub of desperate escape. Weary travelers lug bags and carry the burden of an uncertain journey.
I am going to ensure this safety and sending my family to Poland.
Are you going to stay here?
Yeah, I'm staying here.
The Russian invasion has made Ukraine a nation of migrants. More than 400,000 have already crossed an international border. And all of these people, with children and pets and belongings, want to join them.
First will be women and children. After that, we will take you to the train.
Volunteers do their best to help. The sheer volume overwhelms.
We are one country, and all the people that came trying to help. We're trying to organize this process because we understand that people are scared and they try to run away.
There's an incredible number of people here at the main railway station in Lviv, just waiting on the platform, hoping for a ride to Poland. But with so many people here and the schedules difficult, there is no easy way to escape the fighting.
Those who make it to Poland are bused to a staging center for refugees. American Ryan Baird now among them.
The car that I had, I was the only one in the car. Hundreds of people were hitchhiking, looking for rides. And I told my driver, we have two extra seats, let's pick up somebody. He wouldn't do it. I mean, it was sad.
He's from Illinois, but had been living in Kyiv with his wife.
It's surreal. I moved to Kyiv in 2019, so it could just, you know, you think it can never happen to you until it happens.
The crossing isn't easy. The journey is long. Leaving is sad. The border guards can be unpleasant. But tens of thousands more wait for their turn out of this war-ravaged place. Aaron Katursky, ABC News, Lviv.
If you are looking for ways to help, we have a list of 10 organizations posted on our website. But if you text the word help to 214-977-6028, we will just send that link straight to your phone.